Hey guys, I really felt led to just put something together. I had this dream and I really just felt I really wanted to share this with some people in this fashion, just because I think it's a little bit more easy to understand if you can visualize with me what's going on and catch my heart. But I had this dream a few nights ago, and to give you context to the dream was myself and one of my assistants who help out with our dream booths that we've been having, where we have the free dream interpretations throughout the community. And when we set up these booths, we have with us a tent, a table, chairs, signage, all kinds of different things. And I've been training some other people to kind of do this better and be involved with it themselves more. So in this dream, I am telling the one person who's been helping me a whole lot, giving them all the responsibility. They were to bring everything to the next booth, to set everything up themselves, and I was just going to meet them there. So the dream progresses. I'm going to meet them at the location where the dream booth was set up, where I'm loading her car, pulling out the tent, the table, the chairs, but she forgot the big sign that we have. And it's a nice, it's a decent sidewalk, A-frame style of a sign. It's large. It's our biggest eye catcher. And I said to her, I said, "Well, where's the sign?" And she says, "Well, I didn't bring it." And I thought to myself, and I was very disturbed, because this is like the most important part of the dream booth, to have this big sign, because it's what draws everybody over. And she forgot the sign. And I asked her why. And she says, "I didn't have room in my car for it." And that was the end of the dream. And I was thinking, I was very concerned, because this is not a good symbol. Very many times, cars represent ministries, be it personal ministry, as in an individual ministry, or a church. I believe this dream is for something larger than me, because the more I've been praying about this dream, I see this car as it does represent a person's ministry and represents a person's individual things that they're putting their heart and soul into. I believe that as I was taking an observer's role, watching people set up to do what I do, to do ministry, but being unable to do it because they didn't have enough room in their car. And this is the word I really believe that the Lord is setting us up for right now, because the Lord says that our cars are too full with too much stuff to be able to handle and fill with the things that God is giving us for us to be able to do the things that He has called us to do. Now, this is further confirmed by the fact that randomly my wife was sitting down and she was reading Prophetic Ministry by Rick Joyner. Very good book. And I read it some time ago, but she was just thumbing through it. Opens up to a random page. And I just want to share with you real quick about what Rick has to say here. Page 167, if you have the version yourself. He says, "Years ago, I was given a prophecy that one of the greatest attacks against the church in the last days was going to come from false brethren. These are not false shepherds, false prophets, or false teachers, but false brethren. They are being sent to steal the children's bread by consuming 90% of the leadership's time, energy, and resources without ever really changing or producing fruits. This part of the devil's strategy is in the last days to wear out the saints, and this one word has probably saved my ministry, my family, and maybe even my life. And I have watched those who do not heed this word pay a terrible price for it." My question to you today is, because I really believe, you know, we're sitting in October, which is a very high, spiritually active month. It's coming into Halloween. It is breaking through with various, you know, New Age cult movements look at October as one of the most important times for them. And I begin to wonder, and I want you to just ask yourself, is there things in my life that are consuming too much time, that are keeping me from doing what God wants me to do? And I want to challenge you in this season, especially as we're moving on to the end of October and the beginning of November, which is the peak of this spiritual season, to purge your life from anything that is hindering you, disabling you, causing you to lose focus, causing you to miss out on the things that God has called you to. Just pluck these things out, put them on pause, even if you got to, just put them on the back burner. I want you to keep in the front of your vision right now what God has called you to do, what you know is near and dear, what you know is true, what you know He has said clearly, and everything else, set it aside for now so you don't lose focus. Don't miss out on what God has for you, and don't get sidetracked by watching and getting focused in on other options. Don't let your car be so full that you don't have room to put the sign in that God needs you to have in your life. Please use this time, and I pray with you. Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray, God, that you would release your people from these false brethren and these time-consuming things that the enemy is using in order to keep your people from hearing your word and doing what you've called them to do, from having not enough time. Father, release time, release patience, release long-suffering, and God, most importantly, release strength to stand firm in the power of the Lord. In Jesus' name, amen.